This is the Bringing Business to Retail podcast, and today we're going to dig in and find out if premium brands can actually cash in on Black Friday and Cyber Monday.
Welcome to the Bringing Business to Retail podcast on selenaknight.com. Stay ahead of the competition by opening your doors to business experts so you can learn, grow, and be inspired. Passionate about bringing business strategies to independent retailers, please welcome your host, Selena Knight.
Hey there, and welcome to today's episode of the Bringing Business to Retail podcast. I'm your host, Selena Knight, the retail strategist, and today I'm going to jump in and do a little bit of a follow-up on an episode that I did just a couple of weeks ago, and that episode was titled Cashing In on Black Friday and Cyber Monday. Now, after that podcast, I had a little bit of a flurry of activity. We had hundreds of people download my free guide, 7 Retail Strategies Guaranteed to Boost Sales Over Black Friday and Cyber Monday. But more importantly, people started asking questions. And I love it when questions get asked because that means that you are thinking about what I have had to say, which is what this podcast is all about. Now, if you don't already know it, Black Friday and Cyber Monday is very fast approaching. Now, Black Friday and Cyber Monday is not restricted to America. In fact, 91% of UK retailers will participate in Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and around 86% of US retailers took part in the Cyber Weekend in 2017. So the fact is, if you are not cashing in on Black Friday and Cyber Monday, there's a pretty good chance that your competitors are. So this question came from one of my Retail Collective members, and she said, I just listened to Sal's latest podcast about Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and now my brain is on overload. We are a premium product in the market, and we don't often discount or by very much. So I would love some ideas for what we could do instead. I'm thinking of maybe some value adds that go up incrementally based on how much a customer spends. Now, my retail customer's average spend is $100. So I'm thinking that maybe the first tier could be $150 to get them over the line for that little bit extra. And this is a question that, since it was asked, has come up several times in a few different groups. I actually just did a workshop for a friend of mine, Kate Toon, who is an SEO expert and has been here on the show. Well, a couple of days ago, I jumped into her mastermind group and I did a retail training. And one of these questions came up about Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and what do you do if you're a premium brand? So clearly, if you have a premium brand, the question is out there, what can you do to actually cash in on Black Friday and Cyber Monday? So before I jump into some of the advice that I gave, let's just start with 3 stats that you should know about Black Friday and Cyber Monday. So in the US, because the US are fantastic at gathering stats, the average spend over that Black Friday, Cyber Monday weekend is $413. That is a lot of cash. And the stores that participate in Black Friday and Cyber Monday see a 500 times increase in traffic. And honestly, that can be a make or break for a retail store and for an e-commerce store. And lastly, stats show that people who shop over the Black Friday and Cyber Monday weekend, as much as you might think that they're shopping for Christmas because it's so close to Christmas, actually, 75% of them are shopping for themselves, which is great news because it means that your offers do not have to be Christmas related. You don't have to use up the promotions that you're going to use for Christmas. Okay, before I forget, if you're looking for some help on how you can actually create a fantastic promotion, head on over to selenaknight.com/UPC and check out my Ultimate Promotions Creator. Inside, you'll find everything that you need to create a profitable retail or e-commerce promotion. So if you're in this same quandary, if you have a premium brand, a luxury brand, or a brand that you just don't want to discount, what are some things that you can do to make sure that you can entice customers over this period of time, because you want some of that $413 spend. You want some of that 500 times increase in traffic, right? So the biggest problems that I see when it comes to premium brands and promoting in this kind of environment are that stores don't want to devalue their brand. And I don't just mean the brand of their suppliers and the products, but their own brand. They don't want to be seen as a brand that relies on discounting, which is completely fair. You know, if you've been listening to the podcast for a while, I'm not necessarily about discounting. I think there are much better ways that you can entice your customers than giving a discount. And I'm going to jump into those in a moment. The second problem I see is brands and stores not wanting to jump on the Black Friday, Cyber Monday bandwagon because they think that they will lose sales in the lead up to that period. They basically don't want to miss out on any revenue. And that is a really fair call, because as a customer, if you know that the store that you love is going to be having a sale, there is a chance that you might hold back. But that isn't always the case. And the third problem I see is some stores don't feel like they actually have anything special to offer. And quite often I see this with brands that produce their own product and they have a really small range. So they really struggle to work out what they can offer that will not devalue the brand, that will not make their customers wait for a sale, but actually do entice their customers to come back and spend with them. Now, remember earlier on, I said that the average customer in the US spends $413 per person. I mean, that is a huge amount of money. So, and I said this in the last podcast, but I just want to reiterate it. Let's put this into perspective. If you've got a modest 5,000 people on your customer database, and just 20% of those people spent that average of $413 with you as a store, that would be a whopping, wait for it, $413,000 in revenue in just 4 days. I mean, if just 10% spent that money with you, that is still over $200,000. So can you see now why I think you should really think long and hard about whether you cash in on Black Friday and Cyber Monday? Is this something that you've been asking yourself? Are you wondering whether you should bother with Black Friday, Cyber Monday? Yeah? Well, I'm going to share with you the solution that I shared inside of my retail collective so that if you have a premium brand, you can implement it as well. The first solution that I gave was to value add products. Now, value adding products means adding product instead of discounting. So you might say, if you buy the shampoo and conditioner together, you're going to get a free travel size of them, which is valued at $15.95 for free. Now, the great thing about that is what it's valued at, the $15.95, is not what it costs you. So by encouraging people to buy more than one thing, so not just the shampoo, but the shampoo and conditioner together. Now, if you're a girl, you know that the conditioner always runs out before the shampoo. Who knows why? It just does. So quite often you'll buy the conditioner every second time that you shop rather than the shampoo. But if you can encourage people to buy bundles of products by having a value add that is not a discount, so it's adding something that is complementary into the bundle, then that's a win if you're a premium brand. I mean, think about it. One of the people who was in Kate's group said to me, well, I don't see Apple doing a Black Friday, Cyber Monday sale. Right, just taking a wild stab here, but you don't have the brand loyalty and the customer buy-in that Apple does, right? But let's just say Apple wanted to do a promotion. One of the things that they could do is offer a free Apple Pen. And I just had a look. Those are valued at around $145 when you buy the new iPad. And as a consumer, you're getting a win-win. Not only do you get the iPad, but you get something that works super well with it. It's the same like the travel shampoo and conditioner. It works perfectly with the regular size shampoo and conditioner. So when it comes to value adding products, the key thing to remember is it has to work well together. You can't just throw two random things together and hope that it's going to entice the customer. The customer has to see value, hence it being called value adding. Okay, The second thing that you can do if you are a premium brand to participate in Black Friday and Cyber Monday and not necessarily be about discounting is to value add solutions. And I have to say, when you are a premium brand, this one is kind of the bomb because your customers aren't price sensitive. So here is something that one of my clients has done when it comes to value adding solutions. Billy has a beautiful fashion store, and she really is one of those people who can just pull outfits together. So what she did was she offered to her top tier clients who shopped in the Black Friday Cyber Monday sale a free styling session with her. As the owner of the business, that comes with some status. Everybody knows that Billy dresses really, really fantastically. And because she's not always in the shop anymore, as I said, there's exclusivity that she will be spending time with you to help you with this styling session. So think about the skills that your team have. Think about what you're great at and see how you can value add some solutions into your Black Friday and Cyber Monday promotions. Now, something else that you could potentially throw in as a value added solution, technically not a solution, but you could think about having your next VIP night and only select people get to come. So maybe if they spend over $700, they get a free ticket to your next VIP night. There is so much exclusivity around that because you're not going to sell these tickets. They're literally going to be given to people who spend a certain amount of money. So the great thing about that is you're rewarding what I like to call your customer royalty, but at the same time, you have this FOMO that is driving people in the background because they want to be part of your exclusive club. So value adding solutions does mean you have to think a little bit outside of the box, but the great thing is they promote so much customer loyalty and so much customer buy-in, because if you think about this and you actually pull out some great ideas, then these are things that your customers can't buy. So even though you might put a price on them, the fact is they're pretty much priceless because only a select few people are actually going to be rewarded. My next solution, and this one is probably my favorite, is I'm going to call it to team up to dream up. One of my amazing clients, Rebecca from Satwa Skincare, and again, she is a luxury brand, and she's worked out a long time ago that her customers don't care for discounts. Every time she tried a discount, nobody bought. And in fact, it really was detracting from her overall brand perception. So what Rebecca did was teamed up with a couple of other businesses. And I have to say, these promotions for her have gone gangbusters. Like, she cannot keep stock on the shelf. Now, Rebecca has a beautiful organic skincare range, and she knew that her customers wanted a touch of luxury. So she teamed up with two other brands, Luck Lipsticks and Long Lashes, which is an eyelash enhancing serum. And between the three of them, they all swapped some product and gave away essentially what you'd call a gift with purchase. Let me just give you an example here. So Rebecca had an offer, which was if you spent $125 with her, customers would get a free Long Lashes eyelash enhancing serum that was valued at $89. So customers were almost getting their entire spend back with this other product. The great thing was, with all three companies on board, there was so much cross promotion that each brand wasn't just benefiting with higher sales, but they were also getting brand exposure to what essentially is their ultimate client. People who were prepared to pay $89 for eyelash serum were also prepared to spend $125 on skincare. Solution number three was team up to dream up. Go and do a collaboration. They're all the rage right now, but make sure, again, they're win-win. Make sure that the company that you're teaming up with has the same kind of ideal client that you want in your store. So there you have it. Three fantastic solutions if you are a premium brand who wants to cash in on a huge amount of traffic and sales that come with being part of the Black Friday and Cyber Monday sales. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode of the Bringing Business to Retail podcast. You can find all of the show notes over at selenaknight.com. If you found something that you heard today particularly useful, I'd love it if you could leave me a review on iTunes or Stitcher. And of course, feel free to share this episode with someone that you think could benefit by listening to it. Want more retail biz strategies? You can watch the Bringing Business to Retail TV show, where each week I'll answer a question or provide you with a simple, actionable retail biz strategy that you can implement in your business right away. If you have a question or a guest, I'd love to hear from you. Drop my team an email at podcast@selenaknight.com, and I'll see you on the next episode. Have a great week.